on 12 News tonight. Milwaukee took notice late last year during a string of co-sleeping deaths of children. And now 12 News investigates and has uncovered one of those deaths is now being treated as a homicide. WISN 12 News' Nick Bohr reports when investigators got test results back after the death of a two-year-old boy, they got a big surprise.
Grief-stricken relatives and family friends sobbed outside the apartment complex near 94th and Sheridan in late September, distraught after a two-year-old boy was found dead. His mom told police he came into her room in the night and lay down with her on an air mattress on the floor, according to a medical examiner's report. When she awoke, she said he was dead. And when police and an autopsy didn't find any trauma to the body, it appeared to be another co-sleeping death in Milwaukee. But a month later, a surprise, when the lab tests came back showing, quote, a high level of morphine in the child's system. Police searched the home back in September and found a pill bottle like this with morphine in it in a bedroom closet. The mother first told detectives she didn't know where the pills came from, but later said she found the pills in the apartment when she moved in and kept them. She insisted, though, she had no idea how the morphine could have gotten into her son's system. We asked a man at the apartment if we could speak with the mom, but he quickly walked away and slammed the door. Milwaukee police have requested charges of keeping a drug house against the mother, but 12 News has learned the district attorney's office is now considering homicide charges and is holding off making a final decision, awaiting further tests from the medical examiner's office. In Milwaukee, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.
The case is still under review at the DA's office. The mother is not in custody. We are not naming her because as of now, she has not been charged.